Bismillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah. My dear sisters and my brothers, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. This is your brother Abdussalam Abu Hanifa. Somebody asked a question about Arafat. Why do we fast it? And are there anything that is special to this day? The act of saying yes by itself, it should be enough, because Allah mentioned Arafat in Al-Quran, in Surah Al-Baqarah, when He subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَيْسَ عَلَيْكُمْ جُنَاحٌ أَن تَبْتَغُوا فَضْلًا مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ. There is no issue at all that you seek some gifts and pleasures from Allah. And then he said, فَإِذَا أَفَضْتُمْ مِنْ عَرَفَاتٍ فَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ عِنْدَ الْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ. So when you descend from the mountain of Arafat, then mention the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala greatly when you get to Al-Kaaba. So as from this hadith here, or this the hadith of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the speech of Allah, Arafat is part of the Hajj. As I have already mentioned in my previous talk about the Hajj and the Eid al-Adha, the misplaced meanings of both, if you have not listened to them, please, I do strongly encourage you, and they are on my YouTube channel. So go there to learn the true meaning of Hajj, the different types of Hajj, and also about Eid al-Adha, and so on and so forth. But here it is enough, as I said in my previous pep talk, that when Hajj comes in, the whole Hajj is a gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for what He has gifted us from the cattle that we eat on a yearly basis. And we mention Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala within a set number of days. Now, when those that are in Hajj, when they are on Arafah, they shouldn't fast, because just the mere of them being in Arafat and performing that great actual ritual of Hajj is enough for them as an act. But for the rest of the Muslim world, the Muslim scholars as a whole agree that fasting the day of Arafah is not compulsory. It's not compulsion at all to fast the day of Arafah. The only compulsion in Islam is fasting the month of Ramadan. Anything else is an option. And Arafah is no different to that. So what is and why should we fast? Well, as it turned out, there is a hadith in Sahih Muslim where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَنَّهُ يَحْتَسِبُ عَلَى اللَّهِ. قال صيام يوم عرفة, the fasting of the day of عرفة for those who are not in Hajj, أحتسب على الله, I rely and I count and I expect of Allah, أن يكفر السنة التي قبله, that He expiates the sins of the year that has gone past of it, that means last year, والسنة التي بعده, and the year that is to come. And this hadith here, my dear sisters and my brothers, we must understand it as it ought to be. And the hadith is mentioned in Sahih Muslim and many other books of hadith. This hadith here has got some things that we should discuss about them. The very first one, as I said, fasting Arafah is not compulsory. It's a completely act where you are free to do as you please. You fast, great. You don't fast, no problems at all. Now, as for the reward, the scholars have differentiated about the issue of the rewards. Now, this one here says that you will have the last year's sins expiated and the next year's sins already expiated. Other scholars said no. The rewards, you will get them in the hereafter. We don't know, because it's only Allah who knows what you will get in the day of, or at least in the last day of resurrection. That's when you get your rewards then. Otherwise, if this year's sins are forgiven and the next year's sins are forgiven just for the fast of one day, a Muslim has got a guarantee to Jannah. And then you have all the other hadith from the other end that makes you see red every time you commit a sin. So it is so easy for someone to go drink wine, fornicate, lie, cheat, backbite, do whatever. And all it takes is the fasting of the day of Arafah and the day of Ashura. And that's it. You've got it, like 2 years for Ashura and Arafah, and the next year is guaranteed. However, the scholars have agreed that major sins, as like backbiting, like stealing, cheating, and all those lyings and all these things, are major sins that will not be expiated. They are not counted when you fast Arafah. What is counted are the minor sins. What Allah expiates and forgives are the minor sins. And anyway, they said, between each salat to the next salat, your sins are forgiven. From Ramadan to the next Ramadan, your sins are forgiven. From a Jumu'ah to the next Jumu'ah, your sins, the minor ones, are forgiven. The issue of the rewards in Islam is greatly debated, because always and always remember that the hadith of Rasulullah ﷺ, as much as they want to say, as I have said it tons of times before, we absolutely have no guarantee that what we say, a hadith, was in fact said by Rasulullah ﷺ. It's only an assumption and a study, and the scholars say beyond a reasonable doubt that we think and believe that Rasulullah ﷺ has said the meaning. As for the wordings, hardly ever we find that Rasulullah ﷺ says something and is reported to us as he said it. It's a small, tiny number of hadith. Most of the time, the great number of times, it is reported to us through the meaning. So when Rasulullah ﷺ says, Siyamu Yawm Arafah, the fasting of the day of Arafah, I rely upon Allah that it expiates the sins of the last year, it means the minor sins. And that's that. You can fast, you can donate charity on that day. Now, for those ladies that are or that have debts that they must fast for Ramadan, they should make up for Ramadan, and they haven't done so. The scholars have disliked the issue of you fasting Arafah before making up the days of Ramadan. However, if you do it, some of them, they say you won't get the reward for Arafah because you must pay Allah what you owe Allah, then you do the other things. However, this remains sayings of the scholars, and Allah knows your intention and He knows everything that is. So if you want to fast Arafah and hope that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you the rewards of that. Now, if you do not fast, will you still get your sins forgiven, expiated? Just this is again a controversial point between the scholars, because don't we say that all the outcome of our actions depends on our intention? Many people fast the day of Arafah, but they don't do it for the right purpose, and their intention is sick. They disobey the whole year throughout and just think like by fasting one day, let's say, they had a good deal out of it. But that is not the attitude. Now, the other point is as well, Rasulullah ﷺ never fasted the day of Arafah. Because according to the scholars of Islam, and again, they differentiated between when Hajj was written upon Muslims. Some of them, they say it was written in the year 5. Others say it was written in year 6. While others say in year 9. And another one says in year 10. But the closest to the truth is those 9 or 10th. And we know Rasulullah ﷺ performed the Hajj in the last year, that is the 10th year. But because of that, he didn't fast Arafah at all. So when Ibn Baz alayhi rahmatullah was asked, how come we tell people that it is a sunnah to fast, that Rasulullah ﷺ said you fast Arafah, but he didn't do it? He said there is no problem with that, because even if Rasulullah ﷺ doesn't do an act of ritual like fasting Arafah, he still points us to doing it, and that's fine. But there is a big issue here, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in countless ayat in Al-Quran, Rasulullah ﷺ sets the example. He cannot, and he has not, and he never did tell us to do something good that he didn't do himself. It's impossible that Rasulullah ﷺ tell us to fast Arafah and it expiates last year's sins and the next year's sins, and then he doesn't do it himself. This is why other great number of scholars as well, they think and believe that fasting Arafah is not as great sunnah as it is well portrayed these days. And always remember, as I said before, when Islam has been politicized, it follows a school of thought. And since these days, Mecca and Al-Madinah are under the authority of the family of Al-Saud, and their man of religion and their belief and the school of thought of Ahmed ibn Hanbal, what is being marketed to the world today is the Saudi Islam. And the Saudi Islam is not the only version. It's the extremist, the most hard, the most tough, the most narrowing version of Islam. And the world believes that if you don't fast Arafah, you've committed a sin, which is absolutely nonsense. It's a complete choice of yours. And as I said, If you expect the reward, only Allah knows the true reward. Again, some scholars in Saudi Arabia these days are calling to actually stop telling people do this and you get the reward of that. Because the Quran has never spoken about what you get. You do an act of goodness, you get 10 rewards. But Allah has not specified what that reward is. And the same thing for fasting the day of Arafah. You do the fasting of the day of Arafah, Allah will reward you. But what exactly? You will only know that in the day of judgment. So when you take the root of the Quran, the ahadith that speak about the rewards do not stand. But obviously when you follow the root of the hadith only, then you have a reward for this and a reward for that and this is for that. And alhamdulillah, there are some scholars now in Saudi Arabia and around the world that are calling to review these hadith that mention the rewards. Isn't it enough to tell people, fast the day of Arafah and Allah will reward you? Isn't it enough to tell people that the reward of what Allah promises is far higher than what has been told to you? The Quran speaks so. But as I said, it has become common sense today that Muslims are in business. They want to know what they will get, what's in it for me before doing act. If I say, subhanAllah, what do I get? They say a palm tree will be planted in Jannah. Who said that? They say a hadith. But then again, the hadith, we are not sure it came out from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and that the hadith have been written 300 years after the death of Rasulullah. How do we know that what has been said to us is 100% true? This is why, my dear sisters and my brothers, the safest way is to stick to the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned Arafah. Allah loves the great deeds in the Hajj al-Akbar, the greatest of the Hajj. And we do them expecting far higher rewards than the expiation of the last year and the next year's minor sins forgiveness. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that this is a will shed more light on why people fast Arafah, and Allah knows more. Wa sallallahu nabiyyina Muhammad, subhanak Allahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.